I can't tell you how much in agreement I am with John, because our society on a whole is pointed in the wrong direction, and it's spending the money in the wrong direction. Let me tell you what I mean. If you look at the PowerPoint I have up here, SAR, that's our sales rate, and it fluctuates, but it's around 8.8, okay, right now, currently. The scary part is, I want you to take a look at what the scrap rate is. The scrap rate is, I heard 12.5 the other day, it's between 12.5 and 14 million units a year. We're selling and replacing half, roughly, of the amount of vehicles that we're scrapping.
It's not even close comparison between doing what I'm suggesting and doing a bailout. A bailout doesn't put people back to work. It doesn't put anybody back to work. It doesn't help the tire industry. It doesn't help all the businesses that are related to the auto industry. It does nothing for them. The bailout does nothing for them but put them out of business because orders are staying stagnant or going down. I want to generate orders. I want to generate sales and get all that working and get all the automobile-related industries back to work. All these people, when you think about it, one out of six, one out of 10 people in this country are employed by the auto industry. And we're not doing everything we can do. We give money to banks, we give money to insurance companies, and they're not doing it for the auto industry to stimulate things.
Most of your new vehicles have a 50,000 to 100,000 mile warranty on them right now. You're pre-owned, you can recondition it, but you can't guarantee anybody anything like that. But the technological advancements, I think, are the real important things. And those are the things that I think the public needs to go to the auto show and see, because you're talking about the 21st century as far as what these cars today have on them. Not only do they have warranties that are over 100,000 miles, they got fuel efficiencies that would help us get off of all this foreign oil that we're on.
So give the taxpayers a $10,000 credit to go in and buy an automobile. It'll dry up the inventory, it'll put workers back to work, it'll get the blood flowing in that industry again. Without putting out all these taxpayer dollars right now, down the road, we'll get a tax credit, but it will stimulate this industry.